try to make it as exciting as possible for the girls because, you know, with us practicing all through the summer and everything, sometimes starting practice nowadays isn't as exciting as it used to be. So we want to make it super exciting for them, really fired up about the season, and we're just ready to get going. So we're glad that you guys are here today, too.
Is the Together Walk something new?
Yeah, we definitely started that last week at our boot camp, and just trying to, you know, gel the team. We've got 7 newcomers, and so we've just got to build that chemistry from the get-go. And I think we grew a lot through our boot camp last week, and I think it's going to take a little time for us to, you know, develop that chemistry and even the leadership that we need for this team. Our team is young, really young, and I think it's important for them to know that they have to have each other to win.
Yeah, with the players that graduated, who are going to be some of the leaders for y'all?
Yeah, that's, you know, it's really yet to be determined. I mean, that's what we're excited about watching, but also developing as well. I mean, I would expect Riley McKinney to step up in a big way. I think Jordan Merritt has a great, you know, opportunity to be a good leader for us, for someone that's come in that's new. And then we've got some young kids that will be great leaders for us. I think Bailey Maupin and Kyla Freeland both has shown a lot of maturity and leadership attributes in the last few weeks.
You mentioned you guys have been working out so much. I mean, all these new faces, the transfers like Jordan, yeah. I mean, how much have they integrated themselves and how has that extra time helped them?
Yeah, it's been good for them to just kind of start getting to know our system and to know how to play with one another. The new kids really look good. I mean, we've had some injuries, unfortunately, to several new kids, and so they haven't been out there as much as we'd like them to be, but the ones that have really taken advantage of it and have blended really nice, and, you know, definitely seen some good combinations out there.
Last year, you had the ability for Dorian to play, so that helped you develop this team. What's it going to take this in its early beginnings for you to get to where you feel comfortable about what you have coming up in November?
Yeah, I think this offseason or this preseason is really going to be important for us to develop that chemistry. And you know, we don't have the extra time that we had last year going to Greece, but our young kids that went last year know what it takes, and they know why we did that, and they saw the fruits of their labor by us making it to the postseason for the first time, winning 20 games in the last 10 years. So I think it's really important for them to understand that it takes time to grow that chemistry and that camaraderie on the court, and I think that they understand that they want to continue to play in the postseason, and particularly in the NCAA tournament. So I think there's been a lot of good from all of that, and I think that the newcomers that are coming on to the team understand what our mission is as well.
As you take a look at the schedule, now that the Big 12 schedule is out, what do you see as the challenges of such an unbalanced schedule?
Yeah, you know, I think the Big 12 is just challenging in itself, clearly, and then now we've added these new teams that we don't know a lot about. But I think it's going to be good for us, too. Like, I like our draws. I like, you know, that we get to play Texas twice. You know, I think there's some real value in playing some of the Texas teams. We play Houston twice. We play TCU twice. I think that's going to be great for our fans. And kind of to renew some old Southwest Conference rivalries, you know. And then obviously having to go out to BYU, having to go up to Cincinnati. I think those are going to be some challenges that we haven't seen before, but that I think our kids can really learn from and grow from. And it just prepares them. Like, they have to know that every time they step on the court in Big 12, they're going to be ready to play.
You mentioned having all these practices and everything. What's different about this one, and what do you want to see this first week of the game?
Yeah, well, the time frame is different, first of all. We can have them out here an extended period of time, which certainly helps. But I think also when you can talk to them about, you know, we have a scrimmage in less than a month, I think that kind of opens their eyes to, like, some urgency of really trying to develop, you know, some fluidity on offense, understanding how we've got a lot to put in on defense because there's a lot of different schemes that we want to run with this team, and because they're so talented and they're so athletic, we really want to be able to use our defense. So I think we tried to put in as much fundamentals as we could in the summer and tried to even develop that a little bit more this fall in our preseason workouts, but now it's going to really start getting down to the nitty-gritty and fine-tuning some things and really making it more game-like, you know, just playing an extended period of time so that they can play for 40 minutes.
How do you expect Jay-Z and the other transfers to how do you expect them to reach out?
Yeah, I mean, I think our transfers are a big piece of what we're doing. I mean, they're really, really talented. Unfortunately, Jazion's not going to be able to play this year. She had a season-ending injury about a month ago, and that's really devastating to us. But at the same time, you know, knowing that we have her back next year is going to be important, and then also just being able to have this time to develop that position a little bit more gives us at least some time to help in that. But she's going to be instrumental in what we're doing. Even on the sidelines, she's been big, really big. Alina, Jordan, and Jada, all I expect to play instrumental pieces for us and Hearts. I think they're gonna bring a lot of experience, but they're really talented players, and I think they just give us a different look on the perimeter that we're gonna need. Yeah, I think it takes a little pressure off our freshmen of having to really step up and perform quickly. We still want them to step in and be impactful for us, but they've got a lot to learn, and you know, they've got to get used to this level. They've got to get used to the pace of the game and the shape that we have to be in also. But I do think that they're talented enough to help us this year, and I think it's just a matter of how quickly they adapt to Division I basketball.
Coach, how's JoJo look?
JoJo's done really well. I'm really pleased with her. You know, we continue to just try to develop her strength because we want to keep her healthy. That's going to be her biggest battle, is just trying to keep her as healthy as we can. But she has really protected the rim for us at a different level. That's been fantastic. She's running the floor really well. And I'm really excited about what she's going to bring to the table this year.
And who of the returning do you think has made the biggest strides from the end of last year to where we are today?
I would say Kyla Freelon, no doubt, just because of the potential that she has. But she has spent a lot of time in the weight room. She's spent a lot of time training and just developing her game. And, you know, last year I think you could see spurts of greatness, and just really she's an athlete that can catch you in an awe moment. And now she's bringing that on a consistent basis. We have really good we have some really good development, and obviously Riley and Bailey, I think that those two have shown a lot of improvement just in their confidence, in their ability to defend and bring the offensive weapons that they both have.
So what's the strength of this team this year, and what do you still think you still need to develop on this?
Yeah, I think the strength is definitely going to be our depth and our athleticism. I think we're going to be a lot longer, a lot faster, a lot more athletic, and we'll be able to extend our defense in the full court, and we create. I think our defense will finally be able to create some offense for us, and I think that's the piece that we've been missing in the past. We are going to have to continue to work on just our togetherness and playing as a team and just understanding how all five pieces have to work together. And you know, our leadership role is going to be huge for us. We're really, really young. We only have one senior that's on the court playing, and you know, we're going to need some young kids to step up and to replace those seniors that we lost last year in the leadership department.
Coach, looking at the freshman and transfers, it looks like there's taller players. Is that a point of emphasis?
No doubt. Yeah, no doubt. We tried to get bigger and more athletic and longer and faster. You know, we needed that in every position, and I think that we did a great job of that recruiting-wise. And, you know, we're going to try to turn them loose and let them play, and I think they'll be really excited.
Speaking of that size,
I mean,
it looks like you kind of lost some interior depth from last season. Do you have any names? Do you think so? Sort of
yeah, finish? Actually, I think we gained some interior depth because, you know, we have Big Jazz and Kelly Mora that are going to supply the girth, if you will, as that strength for us. But then we've got Jordan Merritt, and we've got Kyla, and we've got JoJo, and then Alina also that can play at the four position. That I think all of those kids can really play and can really play different parts for us. And I'm excited about trying to figure out who to put on the floor and what combination is going to be the best for us.
You got time for one more?
And with Jazion out, who are you expecting to sort of fill that point guard role you're expecting?
Yeah, you know, we'll have to do it by committee for sure, and that's how we've kind of done it in the past anyway. But obviously, we have Ashley Chevalier that can play the point for us. I think Jada Wynn can actually play some for us, and she gives us a different look because she's a big guard. I'm encouraging Bailey. I think Bailey is really, really smart with the basketball in her hands, and I think she could be explosive in that position. I mean, but I could go on. I think Jasmine Shavers has a chance to do it for us as well. I think we're going to have to share it, but I think that's also going to be a strength of ours too, is not having just one person that has to carry that load for us.
Thanks, Coach.
Awesome. Thank you, guys. Appreciate y'all being here.